Today we're going to be talking about a writing prompt that will help you identify your masks and will help you start to work through them to find your authentic self. We did a deep dive into what masks are and their importance in a previous episode. I would encourage you to watch that before going through this writing prompt. If you didn't, masks are anything that we do to hide our true selves and project a certain image to the world around us. They're used to mask fears, insecurities, stresses, anxieties. So I think that as humans in general, and as people in early recovery, we're looking for a way to feel comfortable in our lives, a way to feel content, a way to feel confident in who we are and what we bring to the table. And I think that an integral part of this is identifying what parts of us are fake, what shows we're putting on for other people, what our masks look like, and getting rid of those masks will help us achieve the contentment that we're all looking for. This prompt starts with us identifying that there are masks, that there are parts of ourselves that we want to hide from the world, that there are fake ways that we present ourselves in order to gain acceptance, to gain love, to gain success. And the goal is to shed those and gain success from our authentic selves, to be content with who we are. So what I want you guys to do is go grab a piece of paper and a pen or pencil and start writing about masks that you think may be present in your life. Think about just different situations and ways that you present yourself. Really common masks that I have seen are humor masks, ways that you mask yourself by making jokes, by avoiding vulnerable situations, by avoiding sensitive topics, and pivoting to the humor aspect. Another common mask that I've seen is a logic or intellectual mask, where we put these barriers in between and our true thoughts and emotions in order to block us off from the uncomfortable parts of ourselves. A common mask I've seen is the social butterfly mask, you know, diving into like social connections, diving into making other people your priority, making other people happy, and gaining that validation through others instead of from yourself. So a good place to start might be writing down, I had an interaction with an old friend from high school who I haven't seen in many years. I'd been struggling with certain things. I was afraid to let him know how I was doing. I was afraid to let him know where I was at in my life. So instead of being honest and vulnerable with him, I put up this mask. I was like, here's what's going well. Here's what's going good. Here's the positives in my life, instead of giving him a full picture of what I was truly going through. Another good place to start might be an easy example of someone makes a joke that you find inappropriate, instead of letting them know how you truly feel, what you truly think, you laugh and go along with it because you're afraid of that rejection or of that conflict that might arise from it. In doing this, you're harming your self-esteem and you are compromising your own personal belief system to make someone else happy. And that is not a recipe for contentment. As you write these, just know that there's countless instances or moments or ways that we wear these masks. So continue to look inward, continue writing them down, and continue exploring this within yourself. So how much should you write about this topic? I think that's up to you. It's up to what you feel comfortable with. I think that this being an ongoing or living document of what you write and what you explore within yourself is something that would benefit you writing every day if you could. Identifying ways that you're wearing masks, identifying ways that you're not being your true self. If you find something one day, write it down. If you find something a week, a month, a year later, write that down as well. The more conscious you are of these issues and of these masks that you're wearing in your life, the quicker you're gonna be shedding them and returning to your authentic self. So finding your authentic self just means living within your own personal belief system, following your moral compass, and it'll bring you contentment, it'll bring you happiness, and you won't have regret about the things you say or do throughout the day. So what should you expect when you're writing about these masks, about these barriers between you and your true self? Oftentimes you'll find stress, you'll find anxiety, you'll have thoughts of shame and guilt stirred up from past experiences, and that's okay. Part of this process is exploring things that you've done and ways that you've lived in order to find a new and better way to live. And in doing that, you'll find discrepancies between your true self and ways you've acted in the past. That's bound to bring stuff up for you internally, and that's okay. When these things do come up for you, just know that it's okay to step away. You don't have to continue writing. You don't have to continue exploring this. You know, go take a walk, take some deep breaths, listen to music that calms you and soothes you. Find a hobby that helps you think about something else in the moment, and come back to it when you're ready. So I think it's important to remember that we create these masks for a reason. They're effective for us, and we use them in our lives because of the benefits that they have. And another thing I think is important is that every mask isn't inherently good or bad. It's all about how you use it and how it relates to your true self. And we'll talk more about this in a future video. Thank you for watching this video. If you or anyone you know is struggling with addiction, please feel free to click on the website below or reach out to us directly. We'd love to help you.